Hello students, welcome back to the mathematics class. Today I would like to discuss with you the graphical representation of pair of linear equations. Okay, now we know that very well. So the general form of a pair of linear equations. So we have here the general form of pair of linear equation is a1 x plus of b1 y plus of c1 is equal to 0, and we have a2 x plus of b2 y plus of c2 is equal to 0. This is what the general form of a pair of linear equations. Okay, so once we have this is a general form is, so graphical representation. So how we represent these equations on the what? Graph. So we need to understand here. So what I'll be doing means these are the what? X and y. We have the what here? Variables. So we have coefficients a1, a2, b1, b2, c1, c2. By comparing the what coefficients, we can say something. Okay, the solution of this one. Okay, so let me write here a1. So first one. Okay, so the first one I'll compare the ratios of these coefficients. So once a1 by a2, here we have a1, we have here a2, which is okay not equal to b1 by b2. Okay, once a1 by a2, which is not equal to b1 by b2, means we can say the representation of this one. Okay, so the graphical representation. So here we can say the lines are what? Intersecting. The lines are what? Intersecting, isn't it? The lines will intersect. Now the solution of this one, so this is what? Comparing the ratio, we have comparing the ratios. Okay, ratios, and we have this is what? Representation of line, representation of line. Okay, now and solution, we have this is what? Solution. See, isn't it? Now comparing the ratios, once we compare the ratios here a1 by a2, which is not equal to b1 by b2, so we can say the lines are what here? Intersecting, and the solution is unique. And the solution is what? Unique, isn't it? That means only one solution. Now second one, we have a1 by a2, which is equal to we can say b1 by b2, and this is equal to again c1 by c2. Okay, a1 by a2, which is equal to b1 by b2, which is equal to c1 by c2. So we can say representation of line here coincident. Okay, the lines are what? Coincident. So coincident. Okay, the solution is what? Infinitely many solutions. Okay, now third one we have, see, if we can say a1 by a2, which is equal to b1 by b2, but this b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2. Yes, a1 by a2, which is equal to b1 by b2, but b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2, means the representation of line, we can say it is parallel. Okay, parallel. Now the solution is, we have unique, no solution, there is no solution. Okay, so there is no solution. So just you can see, dear students, here what we have, by taking this pair of linear equation, this is the general form of a pair of linear equation, a1x plus b1 y plus c1 is equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. So what we have to be doing here, just we have to compare the ratios a1 by a2, which is not equal to b1 by b2, means the representation of line is what? The lines will always intersect at one point, and the solution is what? Unique solution. Always we will get what? Only one solution. Now if the lines, okay, the ratios a1 by a2, which is equal to b1 by b2, which is equal to c1 by c2, all are equal, means we can say the lines are what? Coincident, and the solution is infinitely many. Okay, now so we have here next one, a1 by a2, which is equal to b1 by b2, and b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2, means the lines are what? Parallel, and solution is no solution. Okay, so I hope this this concept you understood very well. Okay, by taking the examples, I'll explain here. Let me rub this one. By taking the examples, we'll take the example here. Okay, now see. See, I'll take one example. X minus 2y is equal to 0. First example, x minus 2y is equal to 0. 3x plus 4y. 3x plus 4y minus 20 is equal to 0. Okay. See, x minus 2y is equal to 0. 3x plus 4y minus 20 is equal to 0. So this is what the example we have. Let us will check. Okay. Here we can say here a1 is which one here? 1 we have. Okay. Now b1 we have minus 2. Okay. Now c1. So c1 we don't have 0. Okay. So now again a2. So a2 we have 3. Now next b2 we have 4. Next c2 we have minus 20. Okay. Next. See, we'll be compare the ratios here. Now a1 by a2 is equal to, okay. So a1 by a2, what we have a1 by here? 1 by 3. Now next b1 by b2 will write here. So what we have? b1 by b2 minus 2 by 4 we have. This we can write minus 1 by 2. Okay. Next, and we have next one is c1 by c2. So this is 0 by 20 means it is 0 obviously. Okay. Next. So this implies we have, now compare the ratios, a1 by a2, is it a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2? Just you can see here 1 by 3 we have, and here minus 1 by 2 we have, is not equal. So a1 by a2 is not equal to, we can say b1 by b2. Once a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2 means the lines are what? The lines are intersecting. The lines are what? intersecting. Okay, how many solution it has? It has one solution, unique solution. This is what the first example for this. Okay, let me take one more example. Okay, now see, I'll take second example here. 2x plus 3y minus 9. 2x plus 3y minus 9 is equal to 0. 4x plus 6y, 4x plus 6y minus 18 is equal to 0. Okay. So these are the what here? Pair of equation. Now here similarly a1. So a1 how much we have? Here we have a1 is equal to 2. Now b1. So b1 is equal to we have 3. Now c1 is equal to we have it is minus 9. Yes. Next. So we have a2 is equal to how much? 4. Now b2 is equal to 6 and c2 is equal to minus 18. Okay. Now we'll be compare the ratios a1 by a2. So it is 2 by 4. So 2 ones are 2 twos are. This is 1 by 2 will come. Yes. Next b1 by b2. So now we have b1 is 3. 3 by 6. Now this is 1 za, 2 za, 3 1 za, 3 2 za. Next we have c1 by c2. So this becomes we have minus 9 by minus 18. So this is again 1 by 2. Yes, just you can see here. All the time a1 by a2 is 1 by 2, b1 by b2 is also 1 by 2, c1 by c2 is also 1 by 2. Okay. Now here therefore a1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. So A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. If all these are equal, means we can say the lines, okay, the lines are coincident. Coincident. The lines are what? Coincident, isn't it? So this is what the second example, and how many solution does it have? It has a what? We can say infinitely many solutions. Well, now I'll move with the next example. So next we have x plus 2y minus 4, x plus 2y minus 4 is equal to 0, 2x plus 4y, 2x plus 4y minus 12, minus 12 is equal to 0, okay. Now, next, so again a1 we have 1, a2 we have it is a1 we have it is b1 will get here 2 and c1 will get here minus 4. Next a2 we have here 2, b2 we have 4, c2 we have minus 12, okay. Now we'll compare the ratios. So a1 by a2, this is 1 by 2, okay. Now b1 by b2, this is 2 by 4, that means this is again 1 by 2, yes. A1 by A2 is also 1 by 2, B1 by B2 is also 1 by 2. Now let us check C1 by C2. Now this is minus 4 by minus 12, so 4 ones are 4, 3s are 1 by 3, isn't it. Now just you can see here, therefore A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2, okay, which is not equal to C1 by C2. Yes, a1 by a2 which is equal to b1 by b2 and which is not equal to c1 by c2. So what we can say, the lines, representation of the lines, the lines are parallel, okay. So this is what the third example, and I hope you understood very well this concept. This concept is very important, okay. Now I'll move with the next one. So I'll move with the exercise 3.2, okay. Exercise 3.2. Well, so now exercise 3.2. So first question, they are given here, okay. 10 students of class 10 took part in the mathematics quiz, okay. So 10 students of class 10 took part in the mathematics quiz. If the number of girls, is 4 more than the number of boys, okay, 4 more than the number of boys, find the number of boys and the girls who took part in the quiz, okay. See, the number of class 10 took part in the class 10 students took part in the mathematics quiz, okay. So is it in this question how many girls and how many boys they are given anything? Not given, okay. If suppose they are not given, means we need to take some unknown quantities, and that is what we will always take, x and y, okay. So they are not given, so let us will take the number of boys be x and the number of girls be what, y will be take, okay. And total how many they are given? 10 students, okay. Now so this is what first one, let the number of boys be, we can take x, let the number of boys be x, okay. Let similarly we can take the number of girls be, we can take y. The number of boys be x and let the number of girls be y, okay. So how many students were taken the part? So we can say it is 10. So x plus y is equal to 10 students, okay. So this boys plus girls is equal to how much? 10, okay. This is what the equation number 1, okay. Second part they are given here, if the number of girls, okay, if the number of girls is 4 more than boys, okay. So this number of girls is always indicating what? Equal to sign. How much more? 4 more than boys, okay. So we can say x plus 4, this is what we can say equation number 2, okay. So if we have, this is what equation number 2, okay. What we need to find here, find the number of boys and girls who took part in the mathematics quiz, okay. From the pair of linear equation in the following problems, and find their solution by graphically. We need to find the solution by the, this is what algebraically is over. Now we need to go for the what? Graphically. For going up the what graphically, by this one will from the equation, this 1 and 2 will draw the what values, will calculate the values here, okay, from equation 1. From equation 1, okay. Now see, I'll take this is y is equal to 10 plus of 10 minus of x, it is 10 minus of x, okay. Now for this we'll calculate the values. Yes, now x, y. So substitute the value of x here. Can substitute value of x is 4, you will get y is equal to 6. Substitute y x is equal to 5, you will get 5. Okay. Substitute 6, you will get 4. Okay. So these are the what? 1 values. Now from equation 2. From the what? 2. So from equation 2. So from equation 2, this is y already we have. So y is equal to, it is x plus of 4 we have. Okay. Now we'll calculate the values. So here, see x, y, substitute the value of x. So can we substitute x is equal to 2? Okay. So x is equal to 2 substituted means y is 6. Now x is equal to how much we need to substitute here? So substitute x is equal to 6 and y is 10. Okay. Now substitute x is equal to something. Okay. So can take 2, 2 already we have taken, you can take 1, okay, you will get y is equal to how much, 5, okay. So here we need something, it is 10 minus of, okay, y we are taken, 10 minus of x, 4, 6, and we have 5, 5, 6, 4. So we need here one more value, so 2, 6, and here we have y is equal to x plus 4, everything is correct here. Now we need to plot a graph here. So we need to find the how many boys and the how many girls, okay. Well, we'll calculate here one more value. Now so we'll take one more value here. So here what I'll be doing means in the equation number 2, x is equal to, I'll take 3. So y is equal to how much we'll get here? It is 7, okay. Now here in the first equation also we'll take, yes, so we'll take here in this x is equal to, in the first equation here, okay, I'll take x is equal to 3, so y is equal to again 7, yes. Now here 3 7 3 7 is the common, so this is what we'll get here, one unique solution. So on the graph I'll plot this one here, I'll draw the graph now. Okay, for x we have, it is highest is, okay, 6 itself. Now this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, okay. And y we have, it is 7 again. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I'll take here is the 7, okay. Now, so one by one will be plot, 4, 6, x is 4, x is we have 4 and this we have 6. So we'll get this point is here. Now 5, 5, 5 and 5, we'll get this point is here. Now 6, 4, we'll get 6 and 4, one point is here, and next one we have 3, 7. So this point we'll get here, okay. Next, this is the one line we'll get here from here. Next 2, 6, 2 and we have, this is 6, okay. So here one point. Now 6, 10, so y is equal to 10, it will come somewhere here, okay. So 6, 10 I will not plot, 1, 5, x is equal to 1 and 5, this point will get here. Next we have 3, 7, so 3, 7, this point will get here, okay. So the graph will be intersect at the point of x is equal to 3, y is equal to 7, okay. So just you can see here, we can say the number of boys be, x means we are taken 3 it is, okay. The number of boys is 3 and the number of girls are what? 7, okay. So, we can write the answers here, okay. The number of boys, how much? We can say 3 and the number of girls, it is 7, total is 10, okay. So total they are given already, it is 10. So this is what, 3 plus 7 is 10, and I hope you understood very well. So these values you need to plot on the what? Graph. Once you plot on the graph means you will get your correct answers, okay. So next question we have here, 5 pencils and 7 pens together cost rupees 50, whereas 7 pencils and 5 pens together cost rupees 46. Find the cost of one pencil and that of one pen, okay. Next question we have here, see what they are given, 5 pencils, yes. So 5 pencils and 7 pens together cost rupees 50, okay, whereas 7 pencils and 5 pens together cost 46. Well, so 5 pencils and 7 pens, so let second one, let the cost of the, let the cost of, we can say pencils, the cost of pencils be x, okay. Let the cost of pens be y, okay. Let the cost of pencils be x and let the cost of pens be y, okay. So they are given here according to question, 5 pencils and 7 pens, 5 pencils, okay, 5 x plus 7 pen, 7 y is equal to how much? It is together rupees 50, okay, equation number 1. And also they are given here, whereas 7 pencils, 7 pencils plus we have 5 pens, so 5 pens it is cost, we can say 46, okay. Now this is what, equation number 2 we have, okay, equation 1, equation 2. And find the cost of one pencil and that of one pen, cost of one pencil, that of one pen, we need to find here, okay. Now this is what, algebraic representation is over, now we need to go for graphical. From equation 1 will be go here. So now we'll take I'll equate this one into the what, x. So now 5x plus of 7y is equal to 50. Now this is 5x is equal to, we can say it is 50 minus of 7 into y by 7 into y. Now x is equal to, we have this is 50 minus of 7y by it is 5, okay. Yes, well, here I'll draw the table. So we can take 3 values so that we'll get intersecting lines x, y, okay. Now it should be completely divisible, okay. Now we have here 7, if you are taken 7 means it is not possible, okay. Now 14, this is also 2 is not possible, 3, 21 will come, okay. Now I think 5 will possible, okay. Now you can take x, y is equal to here 5. Now once you are taken y is equal to 5, this becomes 7 into 5 is 35. So 15 minus 35, so how much you will get? 15. So you will get, this is 3, okay. Now similarly you can take, this is, well, you can take this is minus 5, okay. So now once you are taken minus 7, 7 into 5, okay, again 35 and 50, how much you will get? 85. So 85 again divided by 5, so you will get this is 1 and again 3 remaining means 7, 17 you will get, okay. So once you are taken here minus 5 means you will get this is x is 17, okay. Again is it any possibility again? 7, 1, no possible. 2, 3, 4, 4 you will get 28, no possibility. 5 only possibility. 6, 7, 6, how much you will get? Again 42, okay. So and 7 again, we have 10, We'll take 10 now, okay? 7 into 10. So this becomes 70. 7 into 10 will get here 70. Now we'll get here minus 20. So minus 4 will get. Okay, y is equal to, we'll take 10. So minus 4 will get here. Yes? Well, next. This is one table. Next will be go with what? One more table. Okay. So for this, from equation 2. Okay. So we have 7x plus 5y is equal to 46. Now this is 7x is equal to 46 minus of, we'll get 5y. So x is equal to how much we'll get here? 46 minus of 5y divided by, we'll get here 7. Okay. So it should be completely divisible by 7. Okay. Now table. So here, well, we need to take the values. Yes, this is x, y. First value you can take it here. So okay, if you are taken here 35 means how much remaining here? 7, 5 and 6. So okay, you can take here 5, 2's are 10. 46, 10 if you are taken means it should be completely divisible by, if you are taken y is equal to 2 means it is a 14. So now 14 means, okay, 46. 46 minus of, will get 14. So 6 will get here 2, and this is 32, not divisible. Okay. So next, again we need to take different values. If you are taken here 7 means it is 35. 4 means 20. Okay. So 20 means 5 fours are 20. So we'll get 46. No, it is not possible. So 5 7 7 5 is again 5, 5 5 is a 25, and we get here again 25 means, and 20 again we have 46 and 25 we need to minus, so 1 will come here, 4 and 2, okay, 21 will get here. Okay, so now we can take here 5. So y is equal to 5 and you will get here 3. Okay, so 1 we got here, 1 value we got. Next, again, you can take, once you got this is a y is 5, so you can take this is minus, no, again, okay, it is possible. So once you are taken minus 5, okay, so this is minus into minus, again we will get 5, 24, 46 and 25, we need to add 6 and 5, we will get 11, so this is 4 and 3, you will get, okay, 4 to 6 and this is 71 we will get, okay, so this is again not possible. So you can take different kinds of values which will be provide you the what? Correct graph. Here already we got 3 and 5. So which are those values, just you can calculate. Now here just you can substitute here y is equal to minus 2. Now this becomes, once you substituted y is equal to minus 2 means it is 5 into minus 5 into minus 2, we'll get 56 divided by 7 means we'll get x is equal to 8. Okay, now we need to substitute one more value. We can go for the what? We can substitute 5 into 12. So 60 will get, 46 and okay, so 1 and 60, 5 into 2, 60. So that means we need to, 60 minus of 46. So we'll get here again, this is 6, we'll get here 1 and we have this is 16. Okay, so we'll get 14. Okay. So this is, we'll get 14. Now we can say it is, okay, y I'll substitute here 12, y, once I substituted y is equal to 12, 5 12s are, we'll get here 60, okay, and this is, we have 46. That means we'll get this is 7 2s are, okay. So we, x is equal to, we'll get here 2, okay. Now, yes, so these are the what here, all values. So once we calculated, x will get here minus 2, okay, x is equal to minus 2 will get. So once we got these all values, we need to plot the what? Graph. Next, okay, so we'll plot this graph. Now this is x axis, we have y axis. Now this 3, 5, so 1, I'll take here 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 17 we have, okay, so I'll only 5, 6 up to here. Now this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and we have 6. Up to 6 I'll take only. Now 3, 5. we have x is equal to 3 and y is 5. Okay, you will get this point here. Next we have 17, 5. I will not go with this. X is equal to minus 4. X is equal to, we have minus 4, minus 2, this is minus 3, and this is minus 4, and y is 10. Okay, so y is 10 means we will get, this is 7, 8, 9, we will get here 10. Okay, so minus 4 and 10 will get somewhere here. Okay, this point will get somewhere here. Now this will become, the line will become like this, will become like this one line. Next again x 3 and y is 5. X 3, y is 5 means it will come here. Next x is 8 minus 2, y is minus 2. Okay, x is equal to 8, on the x axis we will get 8 this side, and y is equal to, we have minus 2. Yes, this is, we will get here minus 1, minus 2. Okay, so x is equal to 8 and minus means this side will get here 1 point. Next again x is equal to minus 2 and we have y is equal to 12. X is equal to minus 2. Okay, we have, on the x is equal to minus 2 we have here, and y is 12. Y will get 12 somewhere, it is offside. So we will get off space here, this is 11, we will get 12, okay, minus 2, and this is 8, again x is, we have 8, so this side we will get here 7, 8, and we have minus 2, y is minus 2, so y is minus 2 means we will get somewhere this side. Now again this is x is equal to minus 2 and we will get y is 12, so one line will come like this, so it will be what, intersects here, so we will get here 3 and 5. Okay, so here we have the common solution 3 5 3 5. Okay, so this is what we can say the solution of this one. Okay, so let the cost of pencils be x. Okay, so the pencils, how many pencils we can say, the pencils, it is 3, and the cost of pens it is 5. Okay, so total 5 plus 3 is 8. So I hope you understood this problem very well. So we'll be continuing in the next class. Thank you.